Hi, my name is Stephanie and welcome back to my channel. Today I will be explaining the Oxford graduation ceremony. I just had mine fairly recently and I went into this graduation having no idea what to expect, which is probably not the best idea to do. So if you want to know more about the Oxford graduation ceremony, or you're just like me and you want to go in way better prepared than I did, then this is going to be the right video for you. So first of all, I'm planning on sharing my experience, showing you some clips for my actual graduation and telling you what actually happened in those clips really. First of all, my graduation was a morning graduation, so we had breakfast in my college prior to actually attending the ceremony. To my college, I showed up fully dressed in subfusc and my graduation gown and my hood. Subfusc is what you would wear in Oxford for kind of like more formal events, not formal dinners, but matriculation, exams, that sort of thing. You wear your subfusc and it consists out of black trousers, white blouse, ribbon or bow tie and a jacket, or tights, black skirt, white blouse, ribbon, that's it. So after my guests and I had breakfast in my college, there were some photographers there that were taking pictures of us, and those afterwards you can order online. They are a bit expensive really. It's always the same company that takes them, but still they're very nice pictures, but I would highly recommend also kind of taking your own pictures while you're there. Then we all went back into a hall and the Dean of Degrees from my college started explaining about the ceremony and what we needed to do. And literally the only thing I remember him telling me was that I needed to say Deo Fidem and I needed to bow, and there was a lot of information. It was going really quickly and essentially we all had no idea what to do. Not his fault, but just the fact that most of us were very, very unprepared. So then we all walked to the Sheldonian. The Sheldonian is the building where graduation will take place, and we were walking there with all of the graduands, the students and all of their guests. Generally for the Sheldonian you only get two tickets, which is not a gopher thing, it's a general thing, so you're only allowed to bring in two guests into the Sheldonian. Sometimes there are spare tickets and if you get lucky you can definitely find like a third or a fourth. So this is also the place where you get split up, so your guest will be queuing outside the Sheldonian to essentially find a seat, and all of the graduands, they will go into the Divinity School, which is right behind the Sheldonian. In the Divinity School, I had to take off my hood and I needed to leave my hood in the Divinity School. If you're a PhD student, you'll leave your gown in the Divinity School. And every single hood has kind of like more of a different significance to it. So mine was green and white because I'm an MST student. So I complete the Master of Studies, which generally are languages. Other students who were, for example, doing a Master of Science, they had a blue and gray one, and the bachelor students have the black with the white fur, like the fluffy ones. After we have left our hoods in the Divinity School, we went outside and queued to go into the Sheldonian. We went into the Sheldonian through like the back entrance and we were then told to seat by degree. So I was sitting on a row together with all other MST students, which also kind of meant that I was split up from my friends at that point. And I was the only MST student there from my college. I was sitting there and I literally didn't know anybody next to me, which is totally fine. Like you're sitting there, you're waiting, you're chatting to the people next to you, you're kind of figuring out what college they're from and what specific MST degree they just finished. So it's kind of a fun thing. And while you're there waiting, your guests come in as well and you see them taking a seat up higher in the Sheldonian, as the students are all on the main floor essentially and all the parents are in the seats that kind of go up, as it's a theater. Also, a funny story, your parents or your guests that are going to visit you, they get a booklet, this one, which has the instructions in it of what the students should do, which is rather funny because it would have been quite helpful to have had these specific instructions prior to be seated in the Sheldonian. It was kind of funny that they gave our parents kind of the manuscript of what we actually needed to do and we were just sitting there having no clue, which was rather funny. But again, like everybody has literally no clue what they're doing, so it's all fine and you just see what happens and you kind of copy that and it all works in the end, so it's totally fine. But it's quite funny that your guests will actually know what you're supposed to do. I'm sure you can find this online somewhere on the website. So when everybody is seated, the actual ceremony starts. Essentially there are three important people. They're sitting on the three thrones, if I may call it that, in the middle of the Sheldonian. And those people are in the middle, the Vice Chancellor, on the right, the Proctor, and on the left, the Register. The entire ceremony will be in Latin. So if you're good in Latin, it's a good chance to brush up some of your Latin skills. If you have no idea, you will recognize some words, but in the end, it's all in Latin. And we as students are just sitting there kind of grasping some words and having generally no clue what they're saying. Again, the booklet has all the translation in it, but we don't have the booklet, so it's kind of a fun experience. The first thing they do, they start with the higher degrees. So that includes the PhD students, the Bachelors of Civil Law, Medicine and Divinity degrees. And all these people go through the process, so if you're not one of those people, you can just sit back, watch what they're doing, essentially copy that, and you're all good. They stand up, they go to the mill, they do the thing, and then they are let out of the Sheldonian. They grab their hoods, and PhD students, they'll actually grab their gown because they get to wear a full-on purple and red gown. They're very distinct. And then they come back into the Sheldonian and people are just applauding them. And that's essentially kind of a mini version of the entire ceremony that's going to happen next. Then after the higher degree people, they continue with all of the master students, again, organized by degree. So you know that it's your time to graduate when they read out your degree and your college and your name. And then you just know it's your turn to stand up, go to the middle, and then you go and stand next to your dean of degrees. Normally you'll hold each other's hands, but because of COVID this year they decided not to do so, so I was just standing next to my dean of degrees. Then one of the deans of degrees, essentially the one in front, will say something in Latin to the vice chancellor, the proctor and the registrar, and then you proceed to bow 3 times to each the vice chancellor, the proctor and the registrar. Then the dean of degrees leaves you there by yourself and you're asked to face the proctor, and the proctor then says something in Latin and you're supposed to reply "Do fidem," which means "I swear." This is essentially an oath that you take to be obedient, loyal and faithful through the university. And then you leave the Sheldonian through the side entrance. You go back into the divinity school where you grab your hood that you left that earlier, you put it on, you help each other putting it on because it has to be folded in a certain way, and you attach it to your button, and then you walk back out of the divinity school again and you're essentially outside waiting in front of the Sheldonian once again to go inside. Again, you organize in degrees and essentially you have to stand there and wait until everyone has left the Sheldonian and everybody has essentially graduated. So it's quite a long way outside really. Then you walk back in with your hood on with specifically only the people from your degree, and you get a bunch of applause from everybody's guests sitting in the Sheldonian, and then you bow one more time to the vice chancellor, the proctor and the registrar, and then you leave again and you're on the side end of the Sheldonian at that point. Then you are asked to line up outside, and also finally for the first time during the entire ceremony you are finally asked to put on your mortarboard like so, because during the entire ceremony you will just carry it, you will not wear it, because it's apparently an Oxford tradition to just carry your mortarboard and not put it on your head. And then you will be asked to essentially make this movement with your mortarboard when the vice chancellor, the proctor and the registrar walk outside of Sheldonian. They all walk past you and they are followed by the higher degree students. After they've walked past, the parents are released from the Sheldonian and it's just time to take a bunch of fun photos really. That was my graduation experience explained. I hope you enjoyed watching this video. I hope this was very helpful to you. Please like, comment and subscribe to stay tuned for more Oxford videos.